Welcome everyone. My name is Double. Yeah, but I'm actually Sean. My name is Sean. But whatever. So today I'm helping my little brother level up and gain money super fast in SAS 4 Zombie Assault. I know some tricks and tips on this game. I figured them out pretty quick. I just started recently playing again, but I have previous experience. So, whatever. He said, so have I, but he doesn't know the things that I do. So we're going to go ahead and help him out. We're going to start a brand new character today. I want a medic class, so we're going to go ahead and create a new character here. And then we're going to hit medic, because I want a medic. In addition to their deadly SAS training, a medic employs a number of fast and efficient means of human tissue repair, so I can heal myself. That is a great resource as a medic. So I've always liked that in video games, so we're going to go ahead and do that there. Choose character name. Let's go ahead and name him. We'll go ahead and name him Phobes. Why not? Sorry for that weird cut. Just had to move that for a second. We're going to go ahead and name ourselves Thubs, like I just said. We're going to go ahead and send that there. Confirm. And see, we start off as level 1, of course, with $5,000. There isn't actually a shop yet, but we can do single player. And my little brother's already done the tutorial, which is Onslaught. I already know what I'm doing, so I'm just going to go to the camera real quick, click back. We're going to go ahead and join him and create a private match. So, we'll go ahead. Oh, I can go straight to the one we need to do. I don't have a private code yet. I'm creating it right now. So, since he's level 2, I'm level 1. He did the first level by himself. So, we're going to go ahead and do Survivors, and that is the best map to make money on. So, we're going to go ahead and give him the code right here. It's going to be... Actually, here. I'm going to get him in the lobby, and we'll be right back. Alright, and we're back. So, he is now in the lobby. He has not made his name yet, but that does not matter. We're still going to help him get some cash. We're going to go ahead and start. What are you doing? Okay. You haven't actually set your username. That's what it is. That's your character name, not your username. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and start the match here. It's going to start in 4 seconds. Alright, so follow my lead. You can go ahead and talk now.
Okay.
So.
It's getting tiring, so, just mouthing.
You're gonna be right there. I'm gonna be up here too. I'm gonna go ahead and get the door open.
Place down one of my turrets.
And this skill will give us a lot of money to begin with. Right now, we don't need a lot because. But once you get that. Stop! Don't go that way! What are you doing? Okay, now we gotta open that. Do that door. No harm, no foul. Just make sure they don't get in this building. And they got in the building.
The people in here were already dead.
No, we got lucky. This was a building where nobody was in. So, you see this loot box? Go ahead and grab.
Yes, I am.
All right, go ahead and grab that in the health pack. Don't go that. Dude, I said follow my lead. Yeah, you're trying to learn from me. You're going to get people killed, and a lot of them. So, let's see if we can fix your mess here. I don't want them going after the doors, and looks like they already are. Come on. I don't have a gun powerful enough to stop them. Yep. Oh, good thing it was just zombies. Nobody's dead yet. Reloading.
This one's a mutant. Help.
Okay. Stay in this area. Do not move. Kill these guys off. Follow me. Do not go anywhere. Over here. What are you doing? Okay. This is the easiest, this is the quickest way to get cash in the beginning. So, shoot these guys. Keep them away from the door. All right, guard the entrance for me. And then come in and get your cash. Nice, you got a turret. Those are useful.
Yeah.
All right, and then we're going to go right across the street here. And we're going to save these guys. Collect all the cash from that.
You missed one.
Open this up. Yeah. And it's zombies. Alright. Alright, no trip. We're gonna come up here now. So, not a lot of people know this, but you actually can get in here. And there's some money. And another money. Alright. So that was just some extra cash there. Usually you can get some items as well, but it doesn't look like there was any there. There's a boss. Let's go ahead and take him out.
He's not a boss.
He's a boss for right now, because we're low level. No, they got in. Alright, some people were killed. It's going to be a little hard for us right now. That was mine.
Okay.
I mean, it could be that I'm also trying to do this level as I'm level 1 and it's the third level and I just started this account. I am really stuck. So.
I was supposed to say that online.
Nobody gives a hell anymore, dude.
Sean.
Hey, dude, what are you running there through there for?
To get more crap.
You're lucky I had grenades.
Yeah, so do I. I got two.
No, like, I literally just saved two buildings because of that.
Oh, they're getting in this one. No, they just got in. Holy crap. I am stuck.
You died. Was there a lot of them?
Yeah,
that was fun. Oh, he's got a chat in his hide, damn it.
Yeah, I was trying to save this though.
Damn, dude. I didn't even get this building open yet.
Wait, where's that other building?
It had zombies in it. There was nobody in there.
Wait, can you break this glass?
Up here, kid. Come on.
I'm here.
Guard that door. I'll guard this. Hurry, they're getting it through your door. They got through your door. They're done.
I didn't know you meant this door. Oh, yeah.
Run into those people before they die.
I just did. This guy.
Clear the remaining infected. So now we just gotta kill the rest of these guys. So we'll go down here.
One he killed. I have one of those super overtures.
Sorry if that was a bad face cam. This is my first time using a face cam. Usually I'm just all over the place with when I'm playing.
Alright.
so we'll go. I'm coming, dude. Chill. So there's about to be a boss fight.
Yep.
Right there. This car is gonna drive away, and we're gonna be left to take care of it. So let's go ahead
and. This is the guy I already fought with.
Yeah, well, he's a minor boss, but he's a boss nonetheless.
Yeah, my turn is gone. Holy crap!
Holy crap. Got him. Alright. Kill the rest of these guys.
Molly Demon
box.
A blue box.
Alright, we're about to be evacuated. So we did get. We did miss 20 people. Chat. We did lose 20 people. That is because we are super low level and this is a higher level. But for saving 40 people when we're this low level is pretty good right now. And I'm pretty excited to see what we got. So on top of what we already earned, we earned an extra $914 down here. And we got more XP than we would have. So I probably did level up, see? So that's going to be a level 2. And I have 3 strong boxes. So I got a new SMG. What's my SMG at right now? It's just slightly improved. I like that. So we'll go ahead and we'll keep that. Open this. Keep that because we actually don't have any armor right now, so we need to throw some on. What is it? Ooh, that's actually a really good rifle. So that was probably because of this level. That's probably me, I mean, because you see the damage right here, it's the little skull mark. And that's gonna be 75. If we click back over to this gun, it's 210. So that's extremely good. So we're gonna switch to that instead. And we'll probably sell both those starter guns. And it looks like we unlocked some rewards. Let's go to the weapons first. And we are going to look at that assault gun and equip it there. And we're going to look at that secondary SMG, the one that does 78, and we're going to equip that in the secondary spot. So now we have 2 guns. Just in case our first runs out of ammo, we have a second one. And this one isn't worth anything, but it's kind of worthless. I never used it after I changed from the first gun. I never used it again. So I'm going to go ahead and sell that now and just get rid of it. And then there's the pistol. You're going to go back. Sorry about the thumb in your face for a second. I'm kind of interested. I haven't played a medic yet, so I'm kind of curious as to see. Ooh, I started with a Kevlar vest. Kind of curious to see what skills they have that are different. Okay, these ones are that. That's the SAS skill. So I had the med kit, and that will prove the amount of heal. Yes, 550. Protective aura. Ooh, I can get something that busts. Revive players 18% faster with 5% more health. I have to stand next to them though. Slow zombies in blast radius by 50% and lowers their resistance by 50. Bad blood melee attackers take damage every time they strike you. When you go down, you heal everyone around you and drop medkits. That sounds pretty dope. I can't get the zombie antidote yet, but that's basically a deadly cloud of gas that will kill all zombies but leave all your friends okay. It's basically a nuke. So, yeah, nuke the zombies when you're level 25. We're gonna go. It's kind of a tough decision. I don't know what I want to do yet. I'm gonna pause and I'm gonna think about it for a second. I'm gonna look in the SAS skills and then we're gonna get back into a match with him and I'll see you guys in a second. Alright, so we're gonna go ahead and do a single player match real quick. As you can see, I'm not level 3 yet, so I can't actually play the survivors match, which means I can't get any money from it. So we're gonna go ahead and do vaccine. We'll just play a little bit, you know. I already showed you the technique. Basically, you're just gonna wanna go to each house front door. I'm going to stand in front of the front door because it'll start tearing it down and then zombies will get in. You don't want that. So you're going to stand next to the door and you're just going to shoot all the zombies that are coming up to the door. You want a pretty high powered damage gun for your level. If you just find the highest power gun, highest damage wise gun you can find for your level and you should be good. If you need to use high damage ammo, you just that's at the bottom of your screen. Right next to where it shows your player information, like level and stuff. Give me 1 second. Alright, and we're back. So anyways, back to that strategy, and then you're just gonna go one house at a time. There is, like, two sections, where you're gonna have to, three sections, actually, where you're gonna have to do with more than one house. If you take the path, you go up, get that first house, and then you go right and stick to the right side, you're gonna get that house. You're gonna go down in that little corner area, get that house, and then you're gonna go back up and get the house across the street and go up that little alley, and you're gonna go just basically follow that path all the way back down. The blue markers will help you in that direction. Anyways, you get the gist of it. I'm gonna go ahead and do vaccine real quick. Sorry about that. I really got to get better at the thumb. I just saw myself. I'm sorry about that. All right, so here we are. We're going to go ahead and go get this vaccine. So see, the gun I just got in that last crate is already doing some mad damage. Gotta reload real quick. Let's go ahead and buy some high damage ammo for that. Why not? I believe there is like a boss on this level, so we'll humor him. Apparently, oh, I didn't see these. All right, we got 3 frag grenades. I saw that on the mini-map only. That was a lucky find. Was not wanting to spend $2,000 on those. All right, so here we are. Reload. Grab that. So there's a bunch of zombies right here. If you want, like, extra XP, just come down here and kill them all. It's not hard, and I believe there is loot in the subway train. Oh, frame drops. Alright, there we go. So now we're gonna go back down here, grab these. I believe that's the only thing in here. This is a secret spot on the map. There's a secret map spot on every map. We're gonna go back and hop in here. Didn't realize I stopped recording. I paused it as soon as I noticed. I think I just bumped the button. So we're gonna go ahead and move that button, of course. And yeah, so I'm just right here in the subway car. I didn't go anywhere. Almost low on ammo. Go ahead and refuel that. And we're gonna run up here and we're gonna go through this. I've already done all the levels. I've gotten all the way to the last stand level. That one's pretty fun, especially when you get to the last man standing game mode. That one's pretty alright. We go up like four cars. So you see how there's another one on the map? It'll end, and once you see that there's not another one on the map, then we're good. Then there's not another one. I believe there's one more after that. No, this is the last one. All right, cool. So this next one's our stop. Alright, go up these stairs. I think the gun we have is a little overpowered just because we did that level 3 level instead of the normal levels we're supposed to. We'd get like a little extra boost in the gun, which is why I'm taking them out so early. So if you want to do that when you first start, that can help give a boost. Oh yeah, we gotta go down here. Access security. Come over here, access that. Oh yeah, there's a secret room right here. And that will basically just tell you right where it's at. So we gotta go to lab 3. So there's one. Oh. I'm an idiot. I almost walked right past 3. I'm gonna go ahead and check all the labs though, because there are stuff that spawns in them. Like zombies and stuff. So XP. Alright, that's a good loot crate. Alright, so there's our first loot crate. Let me explore the area a little bit. I believe there's items and stuff I can get. Yeah, see, like, there's stuff heading everywhere. Like, there's dragon grenades right there. Probably go search some over here. Go this way. You know what? Let's walk off. Let's get it up here. I don't want to go. It'll suck you up into the jet if you go next to it. Oh, there's two right there. A little apartment garage here. Infested, looks like. And there's a med kit in here. But see, that's just more kills, more XP. So, good to little find little stuff like that. And that just goes with mainly every game you play. Like, you just want to explore. It just helps you get a better visual of the map. Just does a lot for you in general. So we're gonna go ahead and hit the jet and get the hell out of here. No deaths, and we got a strong box out of that. Tapped open, and we got some boots. Cool. So we're not actually wearing boots, and we can augment them, which is great. So that means we can put some sort of stat on it. Oh, we got two. 16, 9, and a 7. Ooh, okay. We're gonna snag that. And I just got a titanium strong box. Dope. Let's open that. And it gave us a helmet that I can. Ooh, that's a good one. Alright, let's go. So let's click weapons. Change. My sidearm does 95 at 6 rounds per second. It's pretty dope. Okay, we're gonna upgrade this. Let's see what Ted's put on it. Skeletonize. We'll do it's an SMG, right? Rounds per second. So that's gonna cost us $800, but right now this is what you wanna do. This is why you wanna do the survivors. And we did level up, so we can actually do survivors. But I think I'm going to save that for next episode. I think I'm going to end this here, actually. So I hope, thank you for tuning in. If you did, hope you come back next time. If you enjoyed, drop a like. Leave a comment if you need to fight. I do like constructive criticism. So if you think I need to change something, if I need to improve on stuff, just drop a comment below, and I will definitely read them. So, thank you for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed, and peace.